welcome to your October 2019. This is going to be your general love reading for the beautiful sign of Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus. Now, I got off to a very good start in video number one, and then it cut off. So maybe I was being a little too hard on you, Sagittarius, but I will tell you what I was saying. Before we get into that, hello, hello to everybody. If you're new here with me, hi. If you're returning, welcome back. And if you're subscribed to the tribe, ow, now let's get down. I will be ushering in new energy for you guys with the Sacred Destiny Oracle deck. I have a pre-shuffle Oracle card and a pre-shuffle clarifier to give me some insight because this is a quickie read, okay? And with that being said, I ultimately was able to intuitively tap into your energy and you got the card of wonders. That is a crystal quartz in the background. So for some of you guys, please go and get that stone, okay? If you want to know what a crystal quartz looks like, this is a crystal quartz. This is what's being illustrated in this picture, okay? I'm not going to get into this explanation of this beautiful stone. But while I am here with you, and this is my second time attempting to record this, I've already gotten a good majority of your cards, and I stopped as soon as it went off. I have no idea why I did that. It didn't cut off, it just stopped. That hasn't happened in a while. So we're going to recalibrate and we're going to do this again. So you're getting in your own way. Wonders is a message that is telling you that exciting possibilities are around the corner. You're getting in your own way because you come with your mode of thinking and you come with your expectations and you won't allow destiny and nature to take its course. It's saying that sometimes things won't be that apparent. And as soon as something doesn't occur to you, you instantly write it off as it's not happening, as what's being said. Now remember, this is a love reading. So there are some wonders that you were supposed to allow to take place and unfold, okay? And some of you guys is split into, I don't want to wait, I'm impatient. And other ones would rather just, you're a go-getter. You would rather do it yourself. You're going to go get it. But Spirit is guiding you. This is your personal love reading. Now, if you feel like it resonates more with the person that you're connecting with, then that's certainly your prerogative. But I wanted to do a reading before we start focusing so much more time of the month worried about your partner and what they aren't telling you. I wanted to start talking about you guys and get you back accountable in these relationships because you know that's what Marv is about. Let's go. So the first card is the Nine of Pentacles. Now, you're being guided to let go of expectations, yet you already know this is, you know, they call this the single lady, single man card. You know, you could have, you could be used to carrying yourself a certain way. You could be used to that. I see that there's a change. I see that there has been some truth about why or how you carried yourself or how you obtained those pentacles. And with that Ace of Swords, there's going to be a new truthful beginning moving forward here in the heart of the matter, which further led me to see why you are not allowing yourself to be in wondrous mode or in a state of being able to receive. Because ultimately, that's how, it, you know, it's just the word wonder. You're like, Marv, that doesn't make sense. And if it doesn't, it just means I am translating it as get out of your own way and allow Spirit and Divine to do what it needs to do to assist you. Open yourself up to receive. You can't always know what's coming. Okay? That's in the heart of the matter. You want, there are some things in this card that the Seven of Cups represents about your nature, and you're being guided right now to not want to focus on so much that's there. One thing at a time, make your mind up. You can't have it all. Get out of your own way and allow yourself to start to receive, okay? And then we have the Nine of Cups. Now, this is very telling as well, because when you put these two nines together, something is at a distance. And also, I feel like, oh yeah, something is definitely at a distance here. But something that's at a distance is due to your own behavior. Something that's here at a distance is being represented in a way where you have found wish fulfillment. You are in love and loving on someone and ready to give some cups here. You see yourself with this person. But on one hand, you have your Nine of Pentacles. On the other hand, you have your the Moon card. On the other hand, we have our Nine. Sorry about that. That's my sage. On the other hand, we have our Nine of Cups. So I feel like you have the Seven of Cups in your heart, okay? And you have this, you have these two scales. Do I be by myself? Because that's ultimately what this is here. Do I continue to go about my way on my own and get everything that I need? Or do I go and choose him or her? Together we go toward this Nine of Pentacles. What do I want to do? And of course, your emotions are fluctuating. So this is mutable energy. You are mutable energy. Somebody here, though, is very up and down. And I see it here. But, you know, there's going to be some communication. Quick communication, a quick conclusion, back and forth communication, Cupid's arrows at the bottom of the deck. So if you're cross-watching for a Sagittarius, they're going to tell you what they have to tell you about this relationship. But honestly, I knew that as bad as they want to come in, I'm letting you know, guys, that justice is here. Libra energy. So if there is a court case, anything legal, anything that you've been fighting, any type of alimony, child support, anything that's in the legal system, it will end in your favor, okay? However, this is what's happening. Cross watchers for Sagittarius. They have been holding back. They don't know whether they really want to come in with this Aries energy because of financial losses. So what they're not telling you is that they have actually experienced a huge financial loss that may be embarrassing. And if you do know, they're not telling you everything. So what they have left, they're holding on to it, just as depicted in the energy of this card. And so, you know, in the relationship, it could have been some things that have been done. They can't make their mind up, honestly, cross watchers for Sag, because, you know, that single life is appealing to them as well. Having options is just appealing. Like I started giving an analogy in the last video before it cut off about options and how your energy reader here, I'm Marv, and yes, sometimes I want buffet. I don't just want to go in and have one meal. That's what this energy is. I'm trying to make you understand. And, you know, don't get in the comments talking about, well, he was a lying, cheating, da da da. That is not what I'm getting here. I'm getting a person, a Sagittarius, who may have air, who may have water. Definitely water somewhere, okay? Definitely some water. And earth here, there's some Capricorn, there's fellow fire sign, and, you know, there is some air. There's somebody definitely, I feel like, is coming into a truth of how they operate and accepting how they do things. But what I'm saying here is that this individual, these options are not wrong. I don't see third-party energy here, so I'm not going to bring that. So if you relate to this and this resonates, but the extra, you know, cherry on top is third-party energy, that's fine. But that's not what I'm picking up on, unless it comes out in this Romance Angel Oracle cards. But I'm feeling like these options, this person is a go-getter. This Sagittarian energy here, this person just want to have it. And unfortunately, what comes with it, you know how they say stop hustling backwards? This person doesn't have to cheat on you to get a person. This person doesn't have to cheat on their partner to get a person, because the energy here is pretty much a person that can go out. When they start going and chase that pinnacle, that attention comes with it. So they don't have to go out and physically cheat, cross watchers. Okay? Back to you, Sag. So there needs to be a decision that is made. You basically are trying to figure out what you're going to do. And I feel like you came into a relationship with expectations. And unfortunately, when you came to the door with the expectations, you didn't realize that when you walked past the door, there was expectations that was put upon you. And this isn't, a physical, like this is metaphorically speaking. So you got in your own way. There should have been something left to the imagination, you know, crystal quartz here. I feel like that's definitely, you guys need to get back into just allowing things to unfold. Universe and spirit, what do we have for Sagittarius? We're going to go ahead and pull one romance angel oracle card to get you out of here. So, okay, what do we have here? All right, exactly. I'll take that. Keep an open mind. It's time to talk. Didn't I say that? Look, heart-to-heart conversations. Cupid's arrows, quick communication. Eight of wands, absolutely. And I also have another message for you. So Sagittarius, you're being guided to keep an open mind. And I think it goes directly hand in hand with your wonders message. And then if we take it one step further, keep an open mind about these options. Keep an open mind about these options. You have to choose. You have to choose which one of these cups you want to go after. You can't have it both ways. I feel like, though, the relationship is ascending to a higher level. And honestly, there's going to be an engagement. So this could be someone leveling up. For some of you, it's time to put up a shut up. It's time for you to really understand that you need to get to the heart of the matter here. You need to get to the heart of the matter. Stop chasing the wonders in the world. Make a decision. Make a decision about, stop wondering. That's what we need to do. Wow. That's even better than the first one. Well, whatever you do, I got to show you one more thing. I can't make it up. Now, I did not pull marriage out when I said something will end in justice. But check that out. Engagement, the justice of the peace. Just saying. Somebody could be making a decision that one of the options in this Seven of Cups is engagement. And seeing as how it's been prophesied by the Romance Angel Oracle's deck, I want to say congratulations, because there is a great deal of love here. This is a love that's been long-lasting. This is a love that began years ago. This isn't one of those I'm deeply, madly in love with you right now. This is an already love you type of love, and I'm ready to build. That's what this is. So, again, you know, with your pre-shuffle energy being the Six of Cups, that lets me know that this is a past love or a past soulmate energy. This is not somebody that you just met, you know, 2-3 years ago at the club. This is definitely an energy of someone that has been in your life and that is meant to stay in your life for a long time. Hint, hint. So, you know, I'm just saying, Sag, that's what I see. So, like, share, subscribe to the Marvelous Tribe. I have gotten you out of the way. Now we can start minding your partner's business. Please join me here in a couple days or next week, depending on which comes first, as we explore the energy that surrounds your partner and find out what they are not telling you. And in the meantime, that's that. So I certainly hope it resonated. Like, share, subscribe to the Marvelous Tribe. Go and check out Marvelous Madam Channel 2. And I will see you here next week when we do it again. Bye, Sag.